The Transgender Rights Bill 2016 has been facing a lot of opposition from transgender persons across the country, who have been protesting its tabling in the Parliament in the winter session of 2017. So, what exactly is wrong with the bill? For starters, activists claim the bill doesn't even get the definition of transgenders right.
So, the definition of transgender itself in the bill is very old, it's very incorrect. And it basically shows how confused the writers of the bill, the creators of the bill were when they were actually drafting it, because there is serious conflation between transgender and intersex. Because as a trans person, your body actually has no role to play in your identity, your gender identity. So you're trying to talk about a set of people, and the very criteria by which you are trying to decide which set of people, that itself is wrong. That basically says that unless there is, in their terms, in sort of strict medical terms, ambiguity as far as your physical structure is concerned, as far as your body is concerned, you're not transgender.
So, who is a transgender person?
A trans person is anyone whose sense of gender identity, whose own gender identity as they see fit, does not match the gender that they were assigned at birth. For instance, I'll take my example. When I was born, I was assigned gender female at birth. But from very early age, I knew I am not female, I'm not a woman, I'm a guy. I'm a man. So I am a trans person. I'm a trans man. Someone else who was assigned gender male at birth could also be a trans if the gender identity that they identify with is not male. Intersex people born with intersex variations, are people who, when they're born, they cannot be categorized straightforward into either male or female, which is like the only binary that we understand as a society as far as gender is concerned, who cannot be slotted into either male or female. They are people we call are people born with intersex variations. They may or may not be transgender, because again, transgender itself has to do with the mismatch between your gender identity and the one that was assigned to you at birth.
While a standing committee appointed by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment had come up with recommendations to amend the bill, they haven't been incorporated into the bill that was given to the MPs in Parliament. Currently, the most contentious aspect of the bill is about a screening committee that will decide who is a trans person.
So, another problem with the bill is the fact that it has a provision for a screening committee that's going to decide whether someone is trans or not. This screening committee will have different sorts of members, and of course that itself is problematic, because there will be a medical doctor, there will be a psychologist who will actually assess us and decide whether we are trans or not. So the NALSA judgment of 2014, what it said was that everyone will have a right to decide whether they are, you know, what their gender is, whether they identify as trans or man or woman. That right only resides with the person, the trans person. What about trans people whose preferred gender, the gender that they see themselves in, the gender of choice, is also something that fits within the binary? So, if I was assigned gender female at birth and I go by a screening committee, they're going to say I'm transgender. No, but the gender that I want on my documents is man, because I'm a man.
Activists feel the bill takes a patronizing view of the community, which comes through if one looks at the offenses and penalties section.
Bill overall has not given any thought to how the existing laws that actually have gender as such a major element in them, how will they be reimagined? For instance, protection against sexual abuse. According to this bill, that a perpetrator of abuse against a trans person, the kind of punishment that they can expect is minimum 6 months to maximum 2 years. That's it. For a woman, a cis woman, a punishment for a similar offense is 7 years to life term.
And on top of that, certain provisions in the bill seek to criminalize the very networks that trans persons have traditionally depended on.
Another issue with the bill is that it criminalizes enticement to begging. The problem with specifically saying that begging or any action associated with begging, you know, whether that is enticement or encouragement or what, however they might want to term it, that is problematic, because for a lot of these socio-cultural identities associated with trans persons, begging and what we call badhai in North India specifically, that is a traditional way of livelihood. The other thing which is slightly related and which is also a part of the bill is that anyone who takes away a minor trans star person from their natal family, that will be considered kidnapping and they can be prosecuted. So with these two things, they have actually criminalized the whole existence of these traditional support networks or gharana systems, which are available for trans star persons who are a member of these socio-cultural identities.